try this. You see? It's an earth drink. Prune juice.
Warrior's drink. I was merely concerned for the safety of my crewmates.
Drink your prune juice. How come you never gave him prune juice? I beg your pardon. They said he'd never had it till he came here. Now he can't get enough of it. Well, part of him may feel that way. But there's another part that I've seen. Part that comes in and drinks prune juice.
Let me guess. Klingon blood wine.
Prune juice, chilled.
Prune juice?
If you say so. Am I glad we finally got rid of all those Klingons?
I gotta hand it to you, Quark. You really know how to make your customers feel welcome.
What do I care? All he ever drinks is prune juice.
Let's get back to Mr. Worf. Describe what happened next.
He came in, he ordered a drink, prune juice, I believe, and we started to talk. And then, he got this funny look on his face. He put down his prune juice, looked me right in the eye, and then he said...
I hope they do. Prune juice, extra large.
Have a seat, Commander.
All senior staff report to the bridge immediately.
How did you do it?
Do what?
I ordered a glass of prune juice from the replicator in the Defiance mess. This is what it came in.
You know, for a Klingon who was raised by humans, wears a Starfleet uniform, and drinks prune juice, you're pretty attached to tradition. But that's okay. I like a man riddled with contradictions.
I'm honored.
How could I forget? You're the only Klingon I know who drinks something besides blood wine. But prune juice.
Prune juice?
Forget it.
Oh, no, he's still the same old Worf.
Prune juice, extra large.
See what I mean? Worf.
See, that's a Tarkalian tea for you, a Rectogeno for you, and an extra large prune juice.
Lita, you're on vacation, not at Quark's. You don't have to serve us.
Oh, it gives you something to do.
You have to learn to relax.
Well, that's what you said last week.
And?
And it helped. That and the prune juice.
There. You see?
Aha.
I know what I'm talking about.